Hello, I'm Dr. Payal Dande. Welcome to the learning episode of Bee Farm on the topic Identification of Plant Constituents under the subject Pharmacognosy. Today in our key concepts, we are going to first discuss about the plant metabolites. Then further, we are going to discuss about the significance of secondary metabolites, and we will also look upon the various chemical tests which we use for identification of plant constituents. So after watching this video, you should be able to learn the difference between the primary and secondary metabolites. You should be able to also know the significance of secondary metabolites in pharmaceutical industry. You will be knowing the various chemical tests which are used for identification of the plant constituents. And similarly, you should apply this knowledge later by doing the test for the unknown samples, that is unknown plant extract, and trying to identify the phytoconstituents which are present in it. Now let us first start with the plant metabolites. We know that plant undergo two metabolism, which is known as primary metabolism and secondary metabolism. Now based on the metabolism, they have primary metabolites as the end product of primary metabolism, and they develop the secondary metabolite as the end product of secondary metabolism. The primary metabolisms are the compounds that are being commonly produced by all the plants, and they are the ones which take the part in development, in the overall development of the plant, in the growth as well as in the reproduction of plant. The various major primary metabolites which are being produced by a plant after primary metabolism are carbohydrate, lipids, nucleic acid, proteins, and chlorophyll. And they all take the major concern, like carbohydrates can be used as a storage of food or storage of energy, which can be utilized later. The proteins and the nucleic acid are usually being utilized as the building blocks, right? And the chlorophyll takes part in the photosynthesis. So why do the plant have the secondary metabolism, and why do they produce secondary metabolites? While secondary metabolites which are present or which are being produced are the end product of secondary metabolism, as we have already said, but they do not have any role to play in the plant's growth or development or reproduction. So what is their significance? Their significance in plant is mainly in the defensive mechanism. That means they play a major role or an important role in defending the plants from the herbivorous animals, from the pest, as well as from the pathogens. But why are they important to us? They are important to us because they are the ones because of which the plant exert a therapeutic or a biological activity onto the human beings. Meaning, they are the important components which, based on their chemical structure, exert a particular biological or therapeutic action to treat or cure a particular disease. And that's how secondary metabolites have become very significant in developing the drug. Now let us see what are the major phytoconstituents or plant constituents which are present in the plant, which are important to us. The major secondary metabolites which are found in the plant includes terpenoids, alkaloids, glycosides, gums, oils, resins, and the various important polyphenolic compounds such as tannins, flavonoids, anthocyanins, and coumarins. So as you can see in this figure, that we have said there are primary metabolites which takes the part in the general normal growth of plant development, whereas there are secondary metabolites which are produced and which are majorly having a defensive role. Now, what is the significance of phytochemical screening or plant screening? Plant screening basically is being utilized for the detection as well as for the identification of the different plant constituents which are present in the plant. This is the second major step after extraction. And as we have already said, that extraction is a process where we try to separate these active constituents from the plant using the various solvents as well as using the various extraction techniques. Now, depending upon what the plant contains. Now, having known about the significance of the phytochemical screening as well as the significance of secondary metabolites for us to develop the drug, let us understand how do we identify them. So to know that, we are going to today discuss about the various chemical tests which we have developed in order to identify a presence of particular component or phytoconstituent in the plant extract. So today we are going to talk about the major chemical tests which are being utilized for carbohydrates, for alkaloids, for glycosides, for phytosterols, flavonoids, as well as for tannins. Let us first start with the detection of carbohydrates. Over here, the generalized test which is being used to identify carbohydrate is known as Mollisch test. To conduct this test, you can either use an alcoholic extract or an aqueous extract. Aqueous extract is anytime better. Now, what we have to do is, first we have to add to it alcoholic alpha naphthol solution. And then from the side tube, add few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. If you find a violet or a purple ring appearing at the junction, that you may see that carbohydrates are present in the plant. Generally, most of the plants do have carbohydrates. Now, the second test talks about the detection of glycosides. Glycosides are the components which are the plant compounds which on acid hydrolysis give two major components. One is called as glycol, which is made up of sugar moiety, and the other is a non-sugar moiety, which is known as erglycol. So over here, apart from the free reducing sugar which are present in the plant, we have to check the additional glycosides are present or not. To check this, we have a generalized test, which is a quantitative test to compare the red precipitate, which is formed as the end product, and we are trying to compare which test solution has more red precipitate which is formed. Now let us see how to conduct this test. Take 200 mg of drug or drug extract. So you can use either the drug powder or you can use the drug extract. To this, add 5 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid. Why are we using sulfuric acid over here? Is to acid hydrolyze. That means we are going to conduct the hydrolysis of any glycoside which may be present in the drug extract. Now allow it to boil, that is warm on the water bath, and then allow to cool and filter it. Now to neutralize this, add 5% of sodium hydroxide solution. After neutralization, you have to add 0.1 ml of phthalein A and phthalein B solution to it to make it alkaline. And this you can check by using pH paper. So once it is being made alkaline, you can once again boil it for 2 minutes on the water bath and then allow it to cool. You will be able to see the presence of red precipitate. Now this red precipitate, the quantity of this red precipitate, we are going to compare with the test solution B. Now let us see what we are going to do with the test solution B. Over here we are going to use 200 mg of either drug or drug extract, but we will not hydrolyze the additional glycoside which may be present over there. So what we are going to do, we are going to add plain water instead of the sulfuric acid which we had added in the test solution A. Similarly, now that we have not used acid, we do not have to neutralize using sodium hydroxide. So that's why once again we will add equal amount of water instead of sodium hydroxide, and the rest of the test remains the same. Here we are going to add 0.1 ml of phthalein solution A and phthalein solution B and allow it to boil. After boiling, we will be able to find the red precipitate. Now just simply compare the quantity of the two red precipitate. If you find the quantity of red precipitate greater in test solution A than in test solution B, then you may say that the glycosides are present. Why? Because of the simple reason that test B represents only the amount of reducing sugar which was already present in the drug extract, while in test A, along with the free reducing sugar, we now also have those sugar which has been released after the acid hydrolysis of any glycosides which was present in the plant extract. So this is a very simple and quick test to identify the glycosides. After this, we can go for specific tests which are being used to identify the various types of glycosides which may be present in the plant extract. Glycosides are present in various types, right from anthraquinone glycoside, flavonoid glycoside, saponin glycoside, cardiac glycoside, etc. So for that, different identification tests are later used. So till now, we have discussed about these plant metabolites. We discussed about the significance of primary as well as secondary metabolites for the plants. We specifically talked about the secondary metabolites as they are very important for us as a drug component. And then we saw the significance of phytochemical screening for the evaluation of plant extract. We also discussed about the two important tests which are being conducted. One for So here we will take a break and the rest part will continue in the video lecture number 2. Till then, happy learning. This is Dr. Payal Dande signing off.